Welcome everyone. We're so glad you've chosen to join us tonight. We're so glad you're here. And tonight's story is we're going to talk about when God speaks to Moses. And our verse is from Exodus chapter 14, verse 31b. And it reads, "The people were in awe of the Lord, and they believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses."
Into marvelous light I'm running, out of darkness, out of shame. Through the cross you are the truth, you are the life, you are the way. I once was fatherless, a stranger with no hope. Your kindness wakened me from my sleep now. Now I will come and take this life, take your life. Sin has lost its power, death has lost its sting. From the grave you've risen victoriously. Marvelous light. Lift my hands and spin around. See the light that I have found. Oh, the marvelous light, marvelous light.
Scripture tonight picks up where we left off last week. Moses was just a baby last week, growing up in Egypt. He flees out to Midian, where he becomes a shepherd. So I thought it would be fitting to read tonight's scripture out here with some sheep. The scripture tonight comes from the book of Exodus, chapter 3, verses 1 to 22. So you can follow along with me in your own Bibles. Now Moses was tending the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the far side of the desert and came to Horeb, the mountain of God. There the angel of the Lord appeared to him in flames of fire from within a burning bush. Moses saw that though the bush was on fire, it did not burn. So Moses thought, I will go over and see this strange sight, why the bush does not burn up. And when the Lord saw that he had gone over to look, God called to him from within the bush, Moses, Moses. And Moses said, here I am. Do not come any closer, God said. Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. And then he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. At this, Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at God. And the Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I have heard them crying out because of the slave drivers, and I am concerned about their suffering. So I have come down to rescue them from the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up out of the land and into a good and spacious land, a land flowing with milk and honey, the home of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites. And now the cry of the Israelites has reached me, and I have seen the way the Israelites are oppressing them. So now go. I am sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people, the Israelites, out of Egypt. That's such a scary thing for God to be asking Moses to do. But Moses said to God, who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? And God said, I will be with you. And this will be the sign to you that it is I who have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you will worship God on the mountain. And Moses said to God, suppose I go to the Israelites and say to them, the God of your fathers has sent me to you. And they ask me, what is his name? Then what shall I tell them? And God said to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to you. God said to Moses, say to the Israelites, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever, the name by which I am to be remembered from generation to generation. Go, assemble the elders of Israel and say to them, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob appeared to me and said, I have watched over you, and I have seen what has been done to you in Egypt, and I have promised to bring you up out of your misery in Egypt into the land of the Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, Perizzites, Hivites, and Jebusites, a land flowing with milk and honey. The elders of Israel will listen to you. Then you and the elders are to go to the king of Egypt and say to him, the Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has met with us. Let us take a 3-day journey into the desert to offer sacrifices to the Lord our God. But I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go unless a mighty hand compels him. So I will stretch out my hand and strike the Egyptians with all the wonders that I will perform among them. After that, he will let you go. And I will make the Egyptians favorably disposed toward this people so that when you leave, you will not go empty-handed. Every woman is to ask her neighbor and any woman living in her house for articles of silver and gold and for clothing which you will put on your sons and daughters. And so you will plunder the Egyptians. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Thanks for joining us. This is a reminder for you, if you have not already signed up to be a trunk
at our Trunk or Treat event for October 24th, please do so by contacting me or Cheryl Love, and we'll get you signed up to be a part of that awesome day in the life of our church. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much for the time that we can gather in the middle of the week to worship you and learn more about you. We ask that you be with each of us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Good day, family and friends, and welcome to Family Encounter Night. This past month, we were talking about the story of Moses and the awe, how God chose Moses and took an awful situation of him being down the river in a basket and made it an awesome situation as he led his people out of the hands of Pharaoh. And tonight we're going to continue to look at that story, and we're going to talk about the story where Moses encountered the burning bush, and he took off his sandals, and the scripture tells us to take off your shoes for you're standing on holy ground, and how God called Moses to go and do something that was made people in awe as he helped the people. And God calls you and I to encounter situations where we go, and I don't know about you, but I've never spoken to a burning bush because I think that would be really, really awkward and weird. But God sends other people, maybe family and friends, maybe co-workers, or even sometimes strangers, to talk to us. That conversation is ignited by the Holy Spirit, and those people are messengers of God for to tell us to go and do things that God has called us to do. And in this story, we see that Moses is kind of fearful and frightened and afraid. I mean, he's saying, hey, I am not equipped to do this. And so God sends Aaron to kind of lead him and help him and to speak on his behalf. And a lot of times we go through life, maybe kids, you go through your school day, and family, maybe, and parents, maybe you go through your work day, and you feel like you are not equipped to do what God has called you to do. Maybe you have self-doubt. Maybe you say to yourself that I'm not good enough, I'm not strong enough, or I'm not smart enough to do what God has called you to do. But God has given you the right people around you to help lead you to do the things that God has called you to do. And one of my favorite sayings is that God does not call the qualified, he qualifies the call. And quite often we feel like we're not qualified to do what God has called us to do. Well, he wants us to take a step of faith, take off our shoes, and know that he will qualify us as we go through the process. And so as you go throughout your week, I want you to think about what God has called you to do, and look at ways that he has anointed you or qualify you to do those things. But we have to be guided by the Holy Spirit. He sends the fire, the Holy Spirit, to us to inspire us and to ignite us to do those things that he called us to do. And so that's my prayer for you. It's just for you to realize the things that God has qualified you to do, and be like Moses and take a step in faith and ignite the plans that God has for your life. So our spiritual practice this week is I want you to think about, just sit down and think about if you were in front of that consuming fire, and just be in quietness and be in the Holy Spirit, and just know that you are qualified to do what God has called you to do. And just think about those things and pray about it, and ask God, how can you be inspired? How can you take a leap or step of faith and take off your shoes and do those things that he has called you to do? I hope you have a blessed week. And remember, you are qualified to do those things that God has called you to do. Amen.